Good morning, everyone. Happy Friday, happy Friday, happy Friday. Here we're still dealing with freedom from fear. We're walking in faith and not fear. Today's scripture reference, as we deal with our daily devotional, is coming from 2 Timothy chapter 1, verse 7. And it reads as follows: For God had not given us the spirit of fear, but of power and of love and of a sound mind. And we want to deal with for a topic, only receive what God gives. Only receive what God gives. So since God has not given us the spirit of fear, but of power and of love and of a sound mind, then let's look at this thing today. Let's look at what's happening. When the Bible says God didn't give us the spirit of fear, the first thing we notice about this scripture, the spirit of fear, the spirit of fear. You mean fear is a spirit that is not one that comes from the Holy Spirit? It's a spirit that God did not give. So the enemy is manipulating the spirit of fear to get us out of the promise of God. The spirit of fear is one that the enemy uses to lure us into a place of defeat and failure. The spirit of fear is one that's used by the enemy to cause us to forfeit the blessing and the promises that God has ordained for our life, our protection, our deliverance, our salvation, our ability to love others. For the Bible says even perfect love casts out fear. So fear now can hinder all of these things that relates to God's purpose for our life. And it says God did not give us the spirit of fear. And the moment we recognize God didn't give it to us, it should never be tolerated by a believer. Now, I didn't say you won't ever get fear, that we won't ever feel fearful. Lord knows I have to battle with fear all the time. Something comes up and fear enters in. But now I have to remind myself, wait a minute, this doesn't come from God. So I can't tolerate it. Because whatever you tolerate, you can't change. You will never change something you tolerate. If you want to change it, the first thing is to have no toleration for it. So now, fear tolerated is faith contaminated. Amen? God did not give us the spirit of fear. But then the Bible tells us what God did give us. But God did give us power. God did give us love. God did give us a sound mind. The moment I'm operating in fear, I'm neglecting my power. I'm neglecting the love of God. And I'm neglecting the sound mind of peace and wholeness. So if you want to conquer fear, just receive what God gave. Because if you embrace the power of God in your life and the love of God in your life and the sound mind, the peaceful mind, the whole mind, knowing that God's got me covered on every facet, then fear don't even have a way in. The key to defeating fear is to not tolerate it. Only receive what God gave. God didn't give that, so don't you dare receive it. It doesn't mean it won't creep in. But you don't have to allow it to remain. I'll never forget, my pastor, Reverend Robert C. White, would often say, you can't stop a bird from flying over your head, but you can stop him from landing on your head and building a nest. If fear has overtaken you, you've allowed it to land on you and build the nest there. It's time for you to get rid of it. Only receive what God gave: power, love, and a sound mind. Amen. Have an awesome weekend. See you back here Monday. And even before that, look forward for you tuning in on Sunday. God bless. Until then.
Thank you again for joining us. I pray that that word really blessed your life. And if it did, why don't you share it with someone else that you know could be blessed or helped by it? Let us share God's goodness so that all of us can grow and be victorious as God has ordained us to be. If you didn't do it earlier, please click that subscribe button and also click that notification link so you will be updated when new content is coming. And if you desire to support this ministry, you can click on that Givelify link, search Calvary Baptist Church of Hawthorne, and continue to support God's work. We thank you, we love you, and can't wait to see you again next time.